This conference will now be recorded.
Hi, welcome back. In this session, I will show you how we can set up MuleFor. For that, we need to install Java because the Mule ESB runs on top of Java. Basically, it is a Java platform. So we need to install Java first, then set up the environment variables. Next, we need to install Maven and we need to set up the environment variables because Maven is a building tool and we need it. In coming sessions, we will see what is the use of Maven, why we need to install. But for now, let's go ahead and install it, then set up the environment variables. Then we will set up Endpoint Studio. Endpoint Studio is one where we usually do Mule ESB development. And next, we need to install Postman. A Postman is a testing tool which is usually used to test whatever we develop in Mule ESB. Let's see installation of one by one. First, we need to download Java, Maven, Endpoint Studio, Postman. Then I will show you how we can install and set up environment variables one by one. Let's go to Chrome. Just type as Java 1.8 download. Because the current Mule version, which is Mule 4 above, need Java 1.8. So just click on it. Even though you see a lot of tabs here, go for Oracle product because the Java has supplied by the Oracle. Click here. And if you scroll down, we would be able to see the JDK with respect to the operating system. I have Windows 64-bit, so I should go for download of Windows 64-bit. If you use Windows 32, then go for it. Click here, then accept the terms and conditions. Now click on download JDK. Once we click on this, it will ask us to log into the Oracle. Then only we would be able to download it. I already have Oracle account. I go ahead and I download it. But if you don't have Oracle account, go to create account and create it. Click on sign in. Now the JDK file will be downloaded for me. So it is downloading. And next, let's go ahead and download Maven. So Maven download. Go to Apache Maven, it is supplied by Apache. And since I am using Windows, I can go for binary zip file so that I can extract it and I can make use of it. Click on this. So we can go ahead with whatever the latest version is available. No problem for this. And next, I am going to download Endpoint Studio. So just type Endpoint Studio download, then go to MuleSoft.com since it has provided by MuleSoft. Then here we need to provide these details. Just select operating system, give first name, then last name. Then we can give some random email ID. Let me give my email ID here. And company, let me give it as own. Job title, let it be fresher. And phone number, we can give any random number. Let me give some random number. Then I agree, click on download. So it will download Endpoint Studio for us. Meanwhile, let me open one more tab and download Postman. Just type Postman download. Go to Postman, it has supplied by the Postman. just choose the agent per which OS and per which bit is required. Now, all softwares will be downloaded. Then I copy all these softwares into one common folder called softwares. Then we will do installation of one by one. Well, the required softwares have downloaded. Let's go to downloads, and I am going to take from here to one of the folder, because in future if I wish to use, then I can make use of those again without downloading. So let me create one folder as software and just paste here. So first, as discussed, we are going to install Java, then we will set up environment variables. Then we will set up Maven, then we will set up environment variables. So go to JDK downloaded file, just double click on this. Click on yes, it will ask you want to do these changes, just click on yes. Then click on next. Next. So click on next. The Java has installed successfully. Don't go to next steps. It's just about documentation and developer guides. We can close this window. So now we have installed JDK. Next, we need to set up environment variables for JDK. So right click on my computer, properties, go to advanced system settings, environment variables. Here we need to create system variables. So we need to create one system variable, and also we need to provide the bin location in path. Let's do these two steps. So I installed Java. Yeah, it should be under program file, sorry. Java, now we see JDK and JRE. We need to provide this location until JDK as a system variable. Click on new and provide as Java underscore home. All should be capital letters and provide. Okay. Next, go to path, click on edit. Here we need to provide the path until bin location. So go here, open bin and copy this path. Click on new. Okay. 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 To check whether the Java installed successfully or not, go to command prompt. Just type as Java space hyphen version. Now it will show us the current version that we installed. That means our Java installation has done successfully. Now next we will install Maven. So go to software folder. And here I have Maven. Just let me copy it. Go to C drive or D drive, anything you want. Just put here for easy access. Now just extract it. We need not install it, just it is a zip file. If we extract, fine. Now I have Apache Maven 3.6.3 here. We also need to create same kind of two variables for this. So the root location I have to take until this, same like JDK. Now again, go to my computer, properties, advanced system settings, environment variables. Here again, click on new. It should be provided as Maven home. Maven underscore home, all should be capital letters. And provide the location. Okay. In similar way, we also need to set one more field into path, that is until bin location. So let's go to path, click on edit. Here, let me copy the bin location. It is under C Apache Maven bin. Copy here. Then click on new, paste here. Okay. Done. To check whether Maven installed or not, don't check in the same window. Just close it, open new one. Then again, type MBN space hyphen version. It shows us the installed Maven version. Yeah, it is 3.6.3 and where it has installed. So we are done with Maven installation also. And next, go to softwares folder and right click on the AnyPoint Studio downloaded file. Just extract here. Use 7-zip, install 7-zip in your machine. So the extraction will be done quickly. While extracting it, if it shows any error and asking you to continue, don't do it. That error happens whenever you rename this file. I would suggest don't rename this file, keep it as it is and extract it. After that, once it extracted, here, whatever the name you want to keep, you can keep. So here, after extracting it, I have got it as AnyPoint Studio. In the future, I want to get latest AnyPoint Studio. Then while extracting that, again, it will come as AnyPoint Studio so that both can be configured. To avoid that, I can simply rename it. As iPhone, the studio version 7.3.4. Done. Now we can go inside it and we can see there is an icon which is the exe file and we can see the studio symbol also. Right click here, just click on send to desktop. It will create a shortcut on our desktop. Either we can open directly from here or for smooth way we can open from here also. Double click on this icon to open the studio. So once we try to open, it will ask us a file location to save the projects there. So whatever we develop inside the studio, all these should be saved in one of the file location. I already have this location. Let me give as some other name. Let me give it as Mule iPhone Studio Workspace. It will create a folder under this location. And whatever the projects I create inside Studio, all will be stored here. So click on launch. Sometimes, whenever we extract Studio and try to work with this, sometimes it can't able to recognize the JDK has installed. So to fix this issue, we need to set up the java.w.exe location in AnyPoint Studio.ini file. Sometimes this issue happens, sometimes doesn't happen. This happens because of the access. So sometimes if Studio can't able to access C drive directly, during those times this issue happens. If and only if the Studio can't able to recognize the JDK, there we need to provide the JDK location to the Studio. Sometimes it can directly able to recognize it, though you don't get this issue. But whenever you get this issue, just click on documentation site here. And here we have an option called troubleshooting. There it was saying that configure a VM text, correct? VM configuration. So it was asking to keep the Java w.exe location where in Anypoint Studio ini. This Anypoint Studio ini file will be available where we extracted our studio. Go to Anypoint Studio where we extracted. Here we can see one file with settings symbol, configuration settings. Right click on this, just edit with Notepad or Notepad++. Here we see vmargs. Just remove args, keep as vm, enter. And now we need to provide the Java w.exe location. Where we will get it? Where we have installed the Java. Let me go there. Go to C drive. Sorry, under program files, Java, JDK, bin. Under this, we need Java w.exe. Type it. JAVAW. Then use down arrow. Select it. Copy. Go to ini file. Just paste here. Save. Control S. Then close this file. Now click on OK. Again, try to open it. Click on launch. The studio will be opened. That's opened. We can maximize it. And about this studio, I explained completely in upcoming session. So there you will understand. There you will understand about this. Now let's go ahead with remaining installation. So we are done the installations of Java, Maven, Anypoint Studio. Next, we are going to install Postman Agent. Go to software. Just double click on this. So it won't ask anything further and it just installs Postman for us. It is a testing tool. Basically, when we develop REST services or SOAP services, from this Postman, we are going to make the request. About this, you will get hands-on with the coming sessions. Don't worry. Apart from these four installations, we also need to install a database server, SFTP server, and a JMS server. In upcoming sessions, whenever we get need with those servers, in that session itself, I will explain how we can install the database, SFTP server, JMS server. Now the Postman agent has installed. Once it gets installed, a shortcut will be created on the desktop. So how we will work with Anypoint Studio and Postman, we will see in the coming sessions. That's all about this session, and we'll see you in next session. Thank you. Happy learning.